Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about the different kinds of foods that you eat in Japan on Hinamatsuri. Hinamatsuri, also known as Girls' Day, is on March 3rd and is meant to celebrate the health and happiness of all girls and women. It is not a national holiday, but it is widely observed by Japanese families. Usually people set up their ohina-sama or princess dolls during this season. There's some that can get pretty intricate, but they're all really cool and super festive. Like with most Japanese holidays, there are symbolic and important food that is involved. Traditionally, Hinamatsuri dishes all adhere to a similar color palette, which includes green, white, pink, and also yellow. For example, there's hishimochi, which is three layered colored mochi. Mochi is a rice cake. Green signifies spring and new life, white long life and fertility, and pink and red is for health and to ward off bad karma. The yellow in some of the dishes refers to the yellow flowers of the nanohana plant, which is the harbinger of spring. So we're gonna go through some of the other dishes. I actually do have some or made some for this video. I haven't celebrated Hinamatsuri in a long time. I used to when I was little with my family. So this is pretty natsukashi and nostalgic for me to do this video. I'm currently in LA, so I couldn't find any hishimochi, which is surprising because usually there's Hinamatsuri stuff everywhere, but this year it was a bit more challenging. But I did get hina arare. This one is a really cute Hello Kitty one. They don't always have Hello Kitties on them, but these are representative of the dolls that you put up. Hina arare is made of rice and it's usually dyed the festive green, pink, and white. There are variations of hina arare in Tokyo from the Edo period. Hina arare are these sort of sugary riced puffed crackers that are dyed. But in Kyoto, Kansai area, they are a sweet and savory colored rice cracker mix. So these are more puffs, the other ones are more crackers. Itadakimasu. They're so good. They're slightly sweet, but not overly sweet. Similar in the States, I would say, is like a corn puff. They sort of taste like that, but a little bit sweeter. I can eat this whole bag. I'm just kidding. So another wagashi or traditional sweet that got popular recently is the Ichigo Daifuku. I really wanted this one and I couldn't find it anywhere, so I'm really disappointed. Ichigo Daifuku is made of fresh strawberries that is wrapped in azuki and then mochi around it. It's festive and lucky in coloring, and also the sour sweet strawberries are actually in season in Japan, which is why these are really popular. And so the next one is sakura mochi. So this is named after sakura, which are cherry blossoms. It is made out of sweet pink rice or mochi that is wrapped in a pickled cherry leaf. I'm not the biggest fan of sakura mochi, but I will eat it and show you what it looks like inside. This one has anko inside, red beet inside. The thing I don't love about it is the pickled leaf. It's pretty salty, but I do like the sticky rice. And next is hanami dango. Hanami is cherry blossom viewing time, and these are really popular during that season. Again, it's the same color scheme, and it has three basically different colored mochi on it. This is probably one of my favorites out of everything. Itadakimasu. So not everything eaten on Hinamatsuri is sweet. Although there are a lot of sweets, which I love. One really, really popular dish is chirashi sushi. Chirashi sushi is made of sushi rice and then a variety of toppings. You could basically put on whatever you want, but for Hinamatsuri, they usually use things that are in the Hinamatsuri color. So for mine, I used cucumber, I used salmon sashimi, ikura, which is salmon roe, kinshi tamago, which is basically egg. I used denbu, which is like a fluffy flaked fish, a salty, fluffy, flaked fish that's dyed pink. It's sort of like furikake, you just like sprinkle it on things. And yeah, so mine's really simple, but I wanted it to be really pink. I love denbu and I don't get to eat it very often, so this is a really nice treat. Another popular savory dish is ushiojiru, which is a soup that is made from kasha. Made from hamaguri clams, which are also in season. It basically tastes like the ocean. It's salty, but delicious, and it's a nice break from all the sweets. The shell symbolizes a joined pair, which symbolizes happy marriage. And lastly, the traditional drink of Hanamatsuri is amazake. It looks and sounds like sake, which it sort of is. It is made of kome koji, which is fermented rice that is also used to make sake. And the consistency is sort of like eggnog. However, unlike regular sake, this is only fermented for a day, so the sugars never actually really turn into alcohol, so it's safe for kids to drink too, if you can get past the flavor. I almost spilled this all over me. I wasn't looking forward to this because I really don't like amazake. It's a really, really distinct flavor. It tastes sort of earthy and musty, slightly sour. Yay. But yeah, that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope that you learned more about Hinamatsuri and the food. I'm probably gonna try to hit as many Japanese holidays that have food related, so if you have any that you definitely want me to get, let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and I hope you have a wonderful Hinamatsuri. Mata ne! Momo.